I welcome Sri Anand Sharma ji for this session. Anand Sharma ji works with the Meteorological Society of India and is a main person in the country who worked on the weather advisories. So we thought it will be very helpful for us to understand how IMD gives weather advisories and then how IMD gives predictions and then crop advisories, so that we also can use the information which is provided by IMD in our own work. Sir, we have people from across the states of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. They all work with farmers directly. Some are from the government of Andhra Pradesh, working as the district project managers for the organic farming, the natural farming project in Andhra Pradesh. And some are working with the farmers producer organizations. And some we have from CSA who are basically from the agricultural science. So we all work with farmers in helping them, giving advisories and then training on better farming practices. So we thought it will be very helpful for us to understand how IMD gives advisories and then how we can use the information which you provide. Welcome, sir. Thanks for agreeing to us. So first, Sharmaji will talk to us and then we will have questions. So be prepared, and then in between, if you have any questions, you can type in the chat box, and towards the end also we will have the question and answer session. Sir, over to you, sir.
Namaskar to everyone, and thank you very much, Nabuji, for giving me this opportunity to interact with our farming community, our planners, our scientists. And as you know, the job of India Meteorological Department is mainly to give the weather forecast and warning to the different users, and among them farmers are our major users. And we have been giving this kind of tailored forecast for the farmers for almost 50 years, but over the past 20 or I should say 30 years, the service has tremendously improved. And as all of us know that climate variability and change affects agriculture, and agricultural activities are affected at each and every level. I mean, right from sowing till harvesting, even post-harvesting, weather impacts the different crops and different farming operations. So naturally, as I said, you know, most of our area in the country is unirrigated. That means farmers are practicing dryland agriculture. They are totally dependent on rain gods. That's what people always say. You know, in India, in rain-fed areas, it's always agriculture is a gamble, because they are totally dependent on the rain god. If they get the timely rains, fine. If they don't get it, then there's a problem. It leads to long dry spells and drought, and then crops withers and the losses are there, and there are cases of farmers committing suicide as well. So seeing this thing, India Meteorological Department started a special service known as weather-based agro advisories, and it comes under our Gramin Krishi Mausam Seva. So this is the name we have given it, Gramin Krishi Mausam Seva. Under that, we give weather-based agro advisories. So as the name suggests, weather-based agro advisories. Basically, what happens is that there are simple advisories. Apply fertilizer or apply pesticide. Those are just simple advice. But here, when we say weather-based advisory, it basically means the advisories are based on the weather predicted for the next few days. So earlier, what India Meteorological Department was doing, we were issuing, all of you know, we have different kinds of weather forecasts. Yeah, I will start with that. So different weather forecasts. One simple weather forecast is your nowcast. This nowcast is the weather forecast for the next few hours, like for 1 or 2 hours or 3 hours. What is going to happen? Is it going to rain? It is very useful for, especially for, like some cricket matches going on or some lawn tennis matches going on. It is useful for that. The next stage comes in your short range weather forecast. Short range weather forecast is forecast for the next 48 hours. So this was a forecast which were issuing earlier by the India Meteorological Department, and we used to issue at state level. But then farming community said, you give the forecast for just 48 hours, And this 48 hours is not enough for us, because by the time you give forecast, it goes to television or on a radio, or then by the time it reaches the farming community, already half a day or one day is gone. So it's only for just one day. And in one day, if I say rain, farmers do not have enough time to, I mean, do the required operations. So they said, you know, at least you should give us weather forecast 5 days in advance. So India Meteorological Department took that challenge and started issuing 5-day weather forecast, which we call as medium range weather forecast. So something like today, I forecast weather for the next 5 days. And even now, we are, some countries are keeping up to 10 days as medium range. But what we do for the farmers right now, it is medium range weather forecast. So what we do in this medium range weather forecast is that this forecast is given twice to the farmers. Although we generate this 5-day weather forecast every day, but for the farm community, what we do is we issue this forecast for Tuesdays and Fridays. Okay. So how is it done? First, the India Meteorological Department. I'll be showing you at the end some of the, yes, I mean, all this through our direct through our website also, if it's possible.
Okay. Yes, yes.
So what happens is that, so we have the supercomputer, we have the global circulation models. With the help of those models, we input the initial conditions, but like what is today's temperature, rainfall, pressure, etc. All those information about the globe goes into that model. This model is run on a supercomputer, and this supercomputer, I mean, has that software that is called the model, general circulation model, and based on that, it generates 5-day weather forecast. So because it is generated by a computer, it is called numerical weather prediction. And the forecast which it gives is about 8 parameters for the farming communities. And these 8 parameters are your maximum temperature, your minimum temperature, and your speed, wind direction, maximum relative humidity, minimum relative humidity, cloud amount, and rainfall. So these are the 8 parameters for which 5-day forecast is generated by the computer assisted model. Okay, this forecast, we call it machine forecast. So this forecast is done at the centralized level at Delhi. And then after that, this weather forecast, I mean, through our web or through other procedures, we give it our state meteorological center heads. Like for example, for Andhra, Hyderabad, we have a meteorological center. So there, the director of that center gets this weather forecast on his computers or through our website. And now what he does is, he does the value addition to it, because that person sitting at the Met Center Hyderabad has more experience of that particular area. He understands the local weather and climate better than the person sitting at Delhi. So what he does is, suppose the model has given some temperatures, it may not be exactly the correct. So, but then this person with his experience and the current weather situation going on there does value addition to these 8 parameters at the each district level. So what he is doing is, he's adding value to the machine forecast. So after that, once he does the value addition, he improves the forecast, it becomes man-machine mixed forecast, and its quality improves. After that, this forecast is, what they do is that, this is a level 2, that if one level it has moved from national level, it has come down to state level. And now what our director or the head of the Met Center at particular state does, say for example, Hyderabad, there are different agromet field units in the state, maybe in the agriculture universities or some institutes. So there, this forecast, which is developed on Tuesdays and Fridays for next 5 days for 8 weather parameters, it is given to the subject matter specialist at the agromet field units, or we also call it DAMU, district agromet field units these days also, but then basically we have, till now we were calling the agromet field units. So there the subject matter specialist is there. He takes that forecast, and what he has a team of experts. Generally what we have done, we have put these kind of agromet field units in the either in the agriculture universities or in the Krishi Vigyan Kendras, where a team of experts is available. When I say team of experts, means there will be a pathologist who is expert in diseases, entomologist about the insect diseases. Then there will be agronomists, soil scientists, horticulture expert, fishery expert, animal husbandry expert. All those experts are available. So now what this subject matter specialist does is, he sits with all these experts and tells them that this is the 5-day weather forecast we have got from the India Meteorological Department. Now, seeing this weather, what kind of advisory has to be given to the farmers? So suppose next 5 days it says, coming 5 days, say for example, you can see this from the picture very beautifully, how the weather forecast from numerical weather prediction is coming, and it goes to the state med center, and from state med center it has come to agromet field unit. So now there the experts sitting there, what they do is that, suppose for example, now next 5 days, take for example, somebody is sitting in Kerala or in Maharashtra, what he will say, look, monsoon onset is going to take place in the coming days, monsoon rains are going to start. So what they will do is that immediately the expert will say, okay, it is this thing, so that we can tell the farmer in advance that next few days Karnataka and Maharashtra is going to get rains. So farmer there can start preparation of the field, because for sowing, they should have enough moisture in the field. So this kind of advisory can be given. And suppose, for example, there is a person in Kerala who has already a crop, and suppose he has to irrigate. So now the advisory will say, look, monsoon onset is going to be there, rains are going to be there. So if you have to irrigate, please do not irrigate as rain is going to come. So now you can imagine, you can save the irrigation. So depending on the weather situation, suppose there is a pest in the main field, an expert comes to know that there is a rain in the coming days. So what should the advisory? Advisory will be like, look farmers, he will tell the farmers, see, you have some pathogen or an insect based disease, and you need to spray chemicals, but please do not spray the chemicals as rain is going to come and your pesticide will be washed away. So you can postpone your pesticide or pesticide application till the rains are there. So this is one method. Here what you are doing, you are saving farmers money, in the sense, because pesticide he has to buy it from the market, one. Second thing is, you are also saving the environment, because if he doesn't know about the weather and he sprays his chemical and rain comes, what will happen is pesticide or fungicide will be washed away. So the farmer will lose his money, one. Second thing is, pesticide either will go into the field leaching into the ground, it will pollute the groundwater, or it will go into some water body where maybe there is somebody growing the fishes, the chemical goes into the fish, man eats it, and it leads to a lot of health problems, health hazards. So what we are doing, we are not only saving the money, we are also saving the environment, and we are also saving the health. So everything is interconnected. So there are various ways with this service. So this expert team does that job, whether what kind of advice they have given to the horticulture expert, what kind of advisory has to be given to a farmer who is growing paddy or wheat. Now, like for example, and we have in the Kharif season, there will be paddy season coming up, transplanting thing. So accordingly, they will make decisions. So once this expert comes to a conclusion based on the weather forecast, a weather-based agro-advisory is generated, and that agro-advisory is disseminated through multiple means. If you see here, it can reach the farmers through radio. And again, we are popularizing the community radio these days, because they have, they can target a particular community over a short period, over a short area. Then through television, these advisories can be disseminated through newspapers, through mobile apps, and now even social media. And then we also have some extension centers in the various agricultural universities and agriculture department. Those, they can also disseminate this kind of information. And there are very many private players also these days, IFCO, and there are some other agencies also there. They're also involved in disseminating the information. So, which we call it public-private partners. So, and what we do right now is this, we are also sending this weather-based advisories and forecasts through SMS over mobile. And already something like, 40 million 4 crore farmers we are reaching through this service. So you can imagine a huge number of farmers are getting this. Now our target is something like 9 crores. This is the data which is available with the agriculture ministry. So again, there is a lot of scope for improvement, but there are some issues here. Some people are saying, farmers maybe getting this kind of information from multiple agencies, so it creates sometimes confusion for them. I don't know, we have to collect more and more feedback here. I will take questions from the audience here. So are they getting this kind of messages from the multiple organization? Is it causing them confusion? That we need to know from the farmers. So that is one issue. And then for finding out that also, what we do is we collect farmers awareness programs from time to time. So that means what we do is that weatherman, along with the experts from the subject matter specialist and experts from the Krishi Vigyan Kendras, all of them go to a particular village. And there what they do is that they sit with them and then they ask them, get weather-based information and advisories? If they say yes, by what mode they get it? That is asked to them. And then, is it useful to them? If it is useful, how it was useful? Like, for example, I can quote from my side one example when I was a director of the Med Center of the Dehradun. So we had one particular this farmers awareness program where I asked the farmer, can you give me some example where you have used the forecast and it has benefited you? He said, yes, I saw you once. You came on television and you said after 72 hours rains are going to come, and it also came in the newspaper. And then my mustard crop was there in the field and it was ready for harvesting. Immediately I harvested the crop. Had I not harvested the crop, the rain drops would have shattered the grains. So then I said, how much money you save? He said something like 1 lakh rupees. So this is the kind of thing, because he got the information timely, so he could harvest the crop. But had he not got the information, he would have lost the crop. So there are many, many such success stories all over the country from different states and districts where farmers have utilized the weather-based agro advisories and they have got benefited. So here we collect the feedback also. And one more very simple feedback. One of the farmers told me once, if there is a very light rain, please do not, indicate in your forecast. I said, why you are saying that? He said, suppose, you say rain, but it is going to be very less rain. So what happens if it's a less rain? You categorically say, then I know. If you say just rain, so it's my irrigation term, and I leave that term, then my next one will come after 15 days. So there is not enough rain, and I'm not getting any water also from the irrigation canal. So it will be lost for me. That was a good learning experience from them. So there are many, many such examples we have. We can learn from them. And then we can also use their traditional knowledge. What is happening is, these farmers have a lot of traditional knowledge. So we need to involve them now into, let us use their traditional knowledge. Let them use our modern knowledge. We have to have a combination of traditional and modern knowledge, and then sit together, co-create products, and that too. Now we have to. Another issue here is that earlier about maybe 15, 20 years ago, we were giving at state level forecasts, and then people said, no, state is too huge. Some of the hilly state, a lot of variability, even the areas also there is at the coast and in the interiors. So then we came down to district level, but then some districts are so huge, there is a lot of variability, that is also not enough. And they said, please give us at lower level. So India Meteorological Department presently is giving district, and now recently has also started block level forecast. So now we have come down from state to district level and district level to block level. So this block level right now, accuracy is a bit low as compared to district level forecast. But nonetheless, all the blocks of the country, the weather forecast is available on our website and people can access. But then that is a machine forecast. Remember, one has to use man-machine mixed forecast where validation has been done. But then what is happening again? when we are saying block level, people are saying not even block is not enough. There is high variability, and we all of them know rainfall is the highest, very highly variable parameter. So people wanted village level forecast, which is a big, big challenge for us. Naturally, village is a very small unit, and right now the kind of models we have, the capability we have is just up to 3 kilometers. So our model, the GFS model which we use for general weather forecast, is it covers about 12 kilometer area. But WRF model which we have is 3 kilometers, so it can cover only up to 3 kilometers. Anything below 3 kilometer, we cannot give the forecast. So remember, there is a limit to predictability. In terms of the spatial as well as temporal. So it is very, very difficult. Sometimes people asking us to say about village level whether it is going to rain on my roof or on in my field. It becomes sometimes very, very difficult to do that. But yes, sometimes when the system is very strong, weather system, we are able to predict even to lower level, because we know entire region is going to get the rains. But when the system is weak, especially in the pre-monsoon season, where the pre-monsoon thunderstorms form, it becomes very, very difficult, because we say in pre-monsoon season, system developed from nowhere within no time. So that kind of systems are very difficult to capture and predict and contribute. This is, I think you are saying, all our year data is shown, well, how many observatories we have and how many units are there and how. Next, can you just, this is our observational network. This is the, number of 130 district agromet field units we have, and we are going to further upgrade. This is some of the financial money. Yes, this is another thing I want to add here is that, like, block level is mentioned here and we are giving it. And then we have recently launched one app called Meghdoot. This is a Meghdoot app, which I think many farmer must have already downloaded it. The issue I was telling was, the main issue is that when we send the SMS, a farmer gets SMS from many, what you call as sources. So it becomes very difficult for him, and sometimes they start ignoring it. So what does the need? Data's concept is that instead of we pushing the products, people should pull out the information. If a farmer requires, if we download the Meghdoot, the mobile, so what basically it has to do, farmer, once you, load the mobile app, you can fetch the information. But in the case of SMS, what was happening, we had a Kisan portal at Ministry of Agriculture, where a farmer has to go and register itself and tell that which crop he is interested in. Otherwise, suppose he says, just simply without mentioning the crop, he's growing, say, paddy, and he will start getting the weather-based advisory for the wheat crop. So farmer has to, register himself at that portal and then mention the crop which he is, or she is growing. So they will get crop-specific advisories. So, but that is what I'm saying. Now we are moving from SMS. Of course, that is also continuing. We want to do now more of, so that farmers are able to pull the information. So Meghdoot app is the app which has been launched by the India Meteorological Department. And I hope it is going to be popular. But then there are some issues with that app as well. So some farmers are reporting from some regions that internet speed may be a little slow. So they find sometimes difficult to load it. It takes a lot of time, so they feel bored. So I hope as the 5G is coming, internet speed increases, this kind of problem will be solved. So I think these are some of the things I wanted to share. And at this moment, I think I will stop for a moment and start taking questions, and then many other things will become more clear. Yeah, these are some of the, farmers awareness program, and this, you are seeing some Meghdoot app, which is getting the, many people are using it and showing them how to use it. This is about that. Even your MSSRF Foundation has also contributed in that. So these are some of the data available.
Thank you, sir. I think it is a good overview.
Yeah.
So few things which we are trying to do is to understand how this the information which is given by the department IMD and as well as the advisory given from the department side
can yes.
at the farmers level, because yeah. There is a lot of local variances are also seen.
Yes, yes.
So we have farmers cooperatives at cluster level. So 3-4 villages together, there is one group which works. So we,
yeah.
at that level, we can use the information which is available in the Make Do tab as well as local observations. Together, can we use the information, and then how do we use that is something we are trying to understand.
Yeah, yeah.
Second, most of the crop advisories which are coming from the university make chemical pesticide recommendations.
I think here there's one important thing I want to know. That see, blindly we should know what was the trend a few years ago. You know, I mean, even you just see a disease and immediately you recommend the pesticide. First thing is that you should never mention in your agro advisory any name of particular pesticide. It should be generic name. No company name should be given. One very important thing. Second is that, you know, there is no need to immediately you see spot a disease and immediately you start saying spray the chemical. No. What we suggest, you know, first, see, there are three things for a disease to come. We call it disease triangle. Host, that means the plant. Pest, either a fungus or an insect. And third is the environment. So we know the host, maybe paddy crop or maybe say potato crop. And we know the pest, say for example, late blight of potato. Then environment. So what kind of environment it needs? It needs high humidity and a moderate temperature. So if we know that 95% humidity is going to be there for say more than 48 hours continuously and temperatures are moderate 20 degree or so, then this pest can attack the crop. So the moment what happens is, you know, we know that these kind of conditions are there and somebody has a potato crop. So what we tell them, please start monitoring your crop. Now the conditions are favorable for the pest to attack. So if you see any symptoms of the disease, please go and remove those twigs or those leaves where the symptoms have appeared. Immediately, there is no need to spray the chemical. So, because who knows in the coming days, weather improves, your humidity comes down. If your humidity comes down and temperature shoot up, then what is going to happen is that the there will be unfavorable conditions for the pest, but favorable condition for the crop. So, no need, the it is not going to spread.
Yeah.
So, you will save the your pesticide, fungicide there. So this is what I say. If the symptoms are above the economic threshold only, and if we know that conditions are going to be favorable for the pest in the coming days, then only we should advise. Otherwise, we should not advise blindly the use of chemicals. Yes.
Sir, I'll just make a very brief translation to my people. So that
okay, no problem.
Their question.
Go ahead.
I'll do that. Yeah. ఇందాక ఆనంద్ శర్మ గారు చెప్పింది ఏంటంటే మనకి దేశవ్యాప్తంగా చాలా చోట్ల ఉన్న వెదర్ స్టేషన్స్ నుంచి వచ్చే ఇన్ఫర్మేషను అట్లాగే శాటిలైట్ నుంచి వచ్చే ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ కూడా వాడుకొని వీళ్ళు నేషనల్ లెవెల్లో ముందు డేటా జనరేట్ చేస్తారు. వచ్చే 5 రోజులకి ఎలాంటి వాతావరణం ఉంటుంది అన్నది, అంటే ఈ రోజు పడిన వాన, ఈ రోజు ఉన్న టెంపరేచర్ ఇవే కాకుండా వచ్చే 5 రోజులకి ఎలా ఉంటుంది అన్న దాని గురించి వాళ్ళు ఒక 8 పారామీటర్స్ మీద డేటా జనరేట్ చేయడం జరుగుతుంది. అంటే మాక్సిమం టెంపరేచర్, అంటే మనకు టెంపరేచర్ ఎంత ఎక్కువ ఉంటుంది, తక్కువ ఎంత ఉంటుంది, మినిమం టెంపరేచర్ ఎంత ఉంటుంది, మాక్సిమం టెంపరేచర్ ఎంత ఉంటుంది, అట్లాగే హ్యూమిడిటీ ఎంత ఉంటుంది, విండ్ స్పీడ్ ఎంత ఉంటుంది, విండ్ డైరెక్షన్ ఎంత ఉంటుంది, రిలేటివ్ తర్వాత క్లౌడ్ ఎట్లా ఉంటుంది, అంటే మేఘాలు పట్టి ఉంటాయా లేదా, తర్వాత వర్షం వస్తుందా, ఇది ఈ 8 విషయాలు మీద ముందు మెషిన్స్ లోని అది కంప్యూటర్లో నుంచి జనరేట్ అయిన ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ నుంచి వాళ్ళు ముందు ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ తీసుకుని అక్కడ రాష్ట్ర స్థాయికి పంపిస్తారు. రాష్ట్ర స్థాయిలో వీళ్ళు మళ్ళా అడ్వైజరీ తీసుకొని అక్కడ ఉన్న అనుభవాల ప్రకారము దీన్ని కొంచెం రిఫైన్ చేసిన తర్వాత మనకి అగ్రో మెటీరియలాజికల్ యూనిట్స్ కి జిల్లా స్థాయిలో వాటికి పంపడం జరుగుతుంది. అక్కడి నుంచి అడ్వైజరీస్ వస్తాయి. అక్కడ మనకి జిల్లా స్థాయిలో డిపార్ట్మెంట్ తో కలిసి, అగ్రికల్చర్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ అగ్రికల్చర్ యూనివర్సిటీతో కలిపి ప్రతి చోట ఇక్కడ ఇలాంటి సెంటర్లు ఉన్నాయి. వాళ్ళు ఈ వాతావరణ పరిస్థితులలో, అంటే ఇంత టెంపరేచర్ కానీ, ఇంత హ్యూమిడిటీ కానీ, ఇంత మేఘాలు పట్టి ఉండటం కానీ, ఇలాంటి గాలి ఉంటే ఏమవుతుంది అన్న దాన్ని ప్రిడిక్ట్ చేసి దాన్ని బట్టి వాళ్ళు ఒక అడ్వైజ్ ఇవ్వడం జరుగుతుంది. ఈ అడ్వైజ్ ఇప్పుడు రేడియోలో వస్తుంటుంది, తర్వాత పేపర్లలో వస్తుంటుంది, ఎస్ఎంఎస్ రూపంలో వస్తుంటుంది. అలాగే ఇప్పుడు కొత్త మనకు మేఘదూత్ అని ఒక అప్లికేషన్, మొబైల్ అప్లికేషన్ తయారు చేయడం జరిగింది. మీరు ఒకసారి ఆ మొబైల్ అప్లికేషన్ మేఘదూత్ అనే దానికి మీరు డౌన్లోడ్ చేసుకుంటే గిన దాంట్లో మీకు చాలా క్లియర్ గా ఆ ఈరోజు మీరు మీ లొకేషన్ ని మీరు ఐడెంటిఫై చేస్తే మీకు మీకు క్లియర్ గా అక్కడ ఉన్న ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ అంతా వచ్చేస్తుంది, ఎలా ఉంది పరిస్థితి అన్నది చూడటానికి. సో మనం ఇప్పుడు అనుకుంటున్నది ఏంటంటే దీన్ని ఎట్లా వాడుకు, నేను అడుగుతున్నది ఏంటంటే ఆనంద్ శర్మ గారిని, ఇప్పుడు ఈ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ వచ్చినప్పుడు చాలా సందర్భాలలో దీంట్లో కెమికల్ పెస్టిసైడ్ రికమెండేషన్స్ కదా ఉంటాయి, మనము మేము ఆర్గానిక్ ఫార్మింగ్ చేస్తున్న రైతులు వాడుకోవాలి అనుకుంటే ఎట్లాగా జిల్లా స్థాయిలో మరి ఈ వెదర్ ప్రిడిక్షన్స్ వాడుకుని మనం లోకల్ గా ఏమైనా ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఇవ్వచ్చా అన్నది దాని గురించి ఆయన చెప్తూ ఉన్నారు. మనం అలా చేయొచ్చు, అలా చేస్తేనే బాగుంటుంది అన్న దాని గురించి. సార్ ఓవర్ టు యు అగైన్.
Yes. So here two, three things more I want to add. One is that they should not blindly follow the weather forecast and advisories issued by the department. They should also see to the ground situation. That is also very important. So ultimately, you know, decision making is his. You know, I cannot decide sitting somewhere far off and tell him, yes, we are giving them science-based solutions. But one thing is that he has to see his local condition as well. That is what I was saying. He should see how much moisture is left in his ground and what kind of weather he is seeing, any clouds in the sky or not. So that he should continue. Some people say that, no, now the farmers need not look towards the skies. No, they should always, we want him to be Meghdoot. That means he should monitor his clouds. And in fact, you know, traditionally the farmers were very good in observations, and meteorology is all about observation, then analysis of that observation and prediction. So let them do that, one. Second thing is that, you know, we have also started, like I said, we started from now, we have nowcast, we have short range weather forecast, then medium range weather forecast, and then we have extended range weather forecast. For some farmers said, even, you know, 5 days is not enough, we want more, give us 1 month in advance, I want to do more planning. So we started extended range weather forecast for 4 weeks in advance, but then we found that, you know, the forecast for the third and fourth week is not very accurate, but 2 weeks it is okay enough. First week very good, second week what we do, we don't say exactly what amount of rain you are going to get or what will be the temperatures like. What we give here is trend means, if it is rainy, will the second week also be rainy or it will be dry, or will it be normal rainfall or below normal or above normal rainfall. So that is one aspect. Second is, are the temperatures going to be normal or they are going to be above normal or below normal. So this kind of trend we give for the second week. So extended range forecast is also given, and then we have a CRIDA, the Central Research Institute of Dryland Agriculture. So what we have a partnership with them, collaboration with them. So we give this extended range forecast to them, and they factor in this information, and this is also quite useful for the farming community. So here again I will add one more thing, then, you know, this is the weather based agro advisory is, you know, like the ideal example of what people call it now, you know, from lab to land. So, you know, see here how in the lab computers generates the forecast, and then you're also using ICT, you know, internet and computer technology, information community technologies, all those technology, computers, internet, web, your mobile phones, all are used, and the information passes from the lab to straight to the land. And it is a beautiful example of response farming. These days everybody is talking about water management, so rain management, all this thing is the precision agriculture. So again, weather based agro advisories is an excellent tool for all these kind of things. And of course, it is also taking care of the sustainability of the agro ecosystem, in the sense that, when I'm saving the water, when I'm saving the pesticide use, when I'm saving the environment, so I'm also making the environment, our ecosystem, sustainable. So that's another component. And one more thing I wanted.
Tell me, sir. So we'll take questions from others also.
Okay, fantastic. That's great. Yeah,
rain predictions are often go wrong.
Yes, very good question. a village level, if the village is far off from the level, okay, fine, very good. I think he's right. See, one thing I will tell you, because I said, you know, right now, we were giving state level, then we came to district level. So we were giving district level weather forecast, but then I said, you know, sometimes the district is so big. Say, for example, Bastar district, it is as big as Kerala. So, and you can imagine, variability from one to the other end. So that is why there are more chances. Then we came down to district level, and then from district level, we came down to block level. So, but then in certain blocks also, there could be a lot of variability. So forecast can go wrong. There's no doubt about it. And another thing one must remember is that forecast will never be perfect and 100%. Reason being, we are trying to imitate Earth and we are trying to understand the atmosphere. And atmosphere is not just simple thing. It is interlinked to the ocean, hydrosphere. It is linked to the lithosphere. It is linked to our biosphere. It is linked to our cryosphere. Cryosphere is Arctic, Antarctic, and Himalayan snow. So all these five spheres are interacting with each other, and it is so difficult to understand all this. But what scientists have done, they have, tried to solve some of the physics laws which governs the atmosphere, and converted it into a software. And it is just an imitation of nature. But then we have not understood the Earth fully. So forecast can go wrong. But yes, definitely it should not go wrong more number of times. Once yes. in a while, it is fine. But if it goes wrong, that means the quality of the forecast is poor. So, but now I feel is with the better models, better tools like satellites and radars, our accuracy has improved. But okay. In addition to that, that's what I was saying. Please do not follow the forecast blindly. You should also take into condition your local knowledge, your ground realities also, and based on that, one should take a decision. And the question was, is SkyMet is also there? But let me tell you here, if you see their network, they don't have any network. They don't have radars. They don't have satellite. And we have the countrywide network of this thing, and our focus is much better. And I'll tell you, what I say is that we are not against anybody. Let there be competitors and let people decide who is giving better facilities and better forecasts. People will go to that. So nowadays, the farmers have access to information from a lot of places. So can definitely they can choose whichever product is better.
No, sir, here we are trying to understand products like say SkyMet or AccuWeather or Open Weather, which are available. They do based on modeling, they give the local information, but they don't have a station locally, right? Do they take the information from you and do that? How do they do? They don't have weather stations.
That's what I'm saying. So I don't want to comment more on that.
No, that's okay. I'm trying to understand.
One thing is that models, you do that and then you interpolate. But the question comes, sometimes suppose you have, say for example, Hyderabad, you have five locations. So if you click at the five location, it will give you all the five location weather forecast. But then you will find it, all the five stations have the same forecast.
Okay.
Right? You go to the AccuWeather also, and if you see the nearby all areas and you click on all those areas and then find out the forecast, they will be having the similar temperature and similar forecast. But when you click, you say, it's giving you the forecast of my village even. So that also, and one has to verify. But if you feel that the forecast given by somebody else apart from IMD, if they feel it is good, they are free to use it, because naturally it is a farmer. He has his effort goes into it, his money goes into it, and he is entitled for a correct and timely forecast. And there's another question by Mr. Vengalag Reddy. He says, please tell me how can access regularly from my mobile. I think probably he wants to know how he can get the weather
information
on his mobile. So see, there are two things. One is that, as I said, if he wants this, the SMS which is given by our services, that Gramin Krishi Mausam Seva on Kisan portal. So for that, what he will have to do is that he will have to go to the Kisan portal. And he will have to register himself there, and then he can get the information. Okay, so that is the one way.
So any we can get for any location, sir.
Pardon?
So we can get for, so on the Kisan portal we can get for any location, or should we mention which location we
want? Location, definitely you will have to give your the name, the location of your place. But naturally, if he says village, so he'll have to say which district, because or which block. So if he mentions the block. But another example I'll give you here is that because we have not started giving forecasts for all the blocks of India.
Okay.
So recently we started that service. So he will have to check up if his block, I mean, the forecasts are available, he can take it. Otherwise, he will have to he will have to use the district level forecast. So district level forecast definitely, because if there's high variabilities in his district, then there could be issues, definitely.
Okay.
One more. Second thing is he can download the Meghdoot app. That also can be done.
Meghdoot app as the district level forecast, not below that.
Yes.
So one of the important information would be for a seasonal forecast.
Fantastic, right. So as how, I said, nowcast,
So where do we get such information, like say, how this tariff is going to be? Even if it is, say, 50% or 40% accurate, it would be very useful for farmers because the crop prices can be made.
Okay, fantastic. Yeah, you're
right. Possible. Is there any place where that information is available?
Okay, fantastic. Yes. See, like, again, I will repeat the things. We said, you know, forecast for the next few hours is nowcast. Forecast for the next 48 hours is short range weather forecast.
Yes.
Forecast from 5 to 10 days, but we are giving for 5 days to the farmers, we call it medium range weather forecast. Forecast for 4 weeks, we call it extended range weather forecast, but we find that in India, we are issuing that, but for 2 weeks, it's okay. Next forecast comes a seasonal forecast or long range weather forecast.
Mm.
As you know, our monsoon forecast, which we give in the month of April for the June onwards, so that we call it seasonal forecast, and it is, I mean, one very important, I mean, job of India Meteorological Department, but the most difficult job, reason being, as the duration of the forecast increases, the forecast accuracy comes down. So there are more chances of going wrong. So, I mean, like last time we had said it is going to be, I mean, normal, but then we got the excess rain. So it happens. This time, India Meteorological Department has said we are going to get normal rain. That means it's going to be 100%, but then with the error of plus minus 5%, which is an error of the model. So there are chances, but then this kind of forecasts are not for the common man. These are more for the planners, because they can plan in advance if the monsoon is going to be normal, what kind of crops, varieties, farmers should be going for it. Because if it's a normal onset and normal withdrawal, long duration crops, but if it will be late starting, then that means the duration will be smaller. So all those, it helps the planners into factoring it with a different kind of operation. Where is it available? Your question was that? Yes, time to time, India Meteorological Department gives the press release. We say that, you know, like seasonally, if it's a pre-monsoon season, is it going to be hot or normal temperatures or above normal temperatures? Or if it's a winter season, is it going to be severe winter or less severe winter? So all these kinds of forecasts are given time to time through our press release, and they're also available on India Meteorological Department's under press release. If somebody goes and checks up, so they are available there also.
Is it available in local languages?
Yes. See, it is like this. Weather-based, what we have done is that I think 13 languages, this weather-based agro advice is available, because we have decided, you know, suppose if I issue weather forecast is English or Hindi for Telangana or for, other regions, Kerala, in that language, people won't understand. So it has to be in local language. So if it is Odisha, it has in Odia. If it is in Kerala, it is in Malayalam. If it is in Andhra or Telangana, it is in Telugu. So they are given, these kind of information are given in local languages. And we are trying to now rope in more of community radios. So I think I will request you also, you know, to please rope in more community radios. That community radios have a lot of advantages, because they can target a particular community of that particular area, one thing. Second thing is, I am promoting community radio. Why? Because there are these days radios available which do not need electricity, they do not need battery. it's called hand winding tone alert radios. Hand winding specially, that means there is a handle behind the radio. If you, I mean, wind it for 60 times, it runs for 1 hour and it doesn't need electricity, it doesn't need batteries. So suppose there is a bad weather also, one can, I mean, through community radio can get the information on his, this kind of hand winding radio. So this kind of technology will be very useful for the farmers as well as for disaster management.
On the website, can you guide us how to go through these, some of these informations, because...
Okay. You know, see, there are two things. What has happened, you know, recently, earlier our first website was imd.gov.in, which was very popular. But then what we were finding out is, you know, whenever a cyclone was coming, you know, lots of people were logging in, and then even our own people were not able to open it. One. Second thing, many people were stealing the data from there and giving the forecast. So somehow now India Meteorological Department has blocked that, and it's only for the internal use. And we have started with a new website now, mausam.imd.gov.in. So general public can go there. It's quite useful. If you can open it from here, and then I can show you where to go and where to find the things. And
this mausam.
Very good. Nice. Very nice. Yes. Yes. So if you see this here, one is that there are specialized forecasts here. Here.
Yes.
You can click on that.
There's a marine forecast.
Marine heat wave guidance, tourism forecast, thunderstorm prediction, air quality, all this power sector. So all this kind of information is available. Fog forecast and all that there. So just a minute here. Can you go below? Is it agriculture is also given there? Or is it separately? And then
no, sir. Just agriculture is not there. So it is up to here. Highway forecast.
Just a minute. Maybe in the other side. This is again, I was mentioning, you know, here you see the long range forecast, which were asking you. You were asking it is like there. First stage long range forecast, second range weather forecast.
This monsoon one. First stage Kerala. Long range forecast.
Yeah, all this the forecast. The monsoon onset over Kerala forecast is also the first June, we had said. First June. You just open it and you can. This was given on 15th of May, but now this was given on 15th. Now you please go to the again back. I'll show you some more things.
This is
so
the
now if you see, you just little scroll it down. You can come down little. Just up. So see if you if you want cyclone information, you can go to cyclone. Monsoon information, you can go to monsoon. If you want to go to city forecast, you can see. Now come to agro advisory. Yeah. This is monsoon, correct? So all the information related to monsoon will be available on this page, monsoon page. But AgroMet Advisory Service, you can come to. AgroMet Advisory Services.
Yes, sir?
Just go up, little up.
Here.
Here also you can, Make Good app is also there. Yeah, you can click on that. So this now you go to your place, Andhra,
Right.
Yes.
So this is the entire district one.
Correct. So all this information will be available. And it will be in the local language. Maybe you can click one of them and see if it is there or not. State bulletins are there. You can see district bulletins, weather forecast, national bulletins. Yes, search here. State. Click on Andhra. State. Select the district. Please see this.
Anantapur.
Correct. And go further down.
So till 3rd it is there.
3rd of June, no? Correct. Friday they must have issued. Correct. So that can, but then I think there should be advisory part also. This is the forecast part.
This is the forecast.
So just a minute. Just go up, little up. Because mainly we are using from other state bulletins. Can you check the state bulletins? What is there in the state bulletin? Yes. Now you click on some particular Is it opening?
No, sir. It is. This is just one page. Below. Yeah.
See, all these are given now.
Right.
Now go further down.
Yes. Next 5 days, this is the rainfall distribution.
Yeah. Up to 3rd of June, you know, all this they have given. All those, now they have given this information also. 4 weeks also, they have given the information. Now advisories are also given.
Agrometeorological advisory for Srikakulam district.
Yes, Srikakulam. So similarly, you can look at for all those divisions.
Okay.
So what is now required from your side, what I feel is, you know, from time to time, first thing is that you can tell the farmer this kind of information is available from here. So what we should have, you know, at the village level, we should have, you know, information kiosk.
Yes, that's we are planning, sir.
Yeah, so information kiosk is there. So what some expert who is expert in, you know, because the farmer may not be able to locate all this, it's a bit complicated for him. But a person who has a background in computers and he knows this thing, he can go, and if a farmer comes, he can guide him. And then one more thing they can do, still simplify the most important thing, put on a big chart or in some screen somewhere at a like hospital or some bank, so where people frequently go, so that they can have this kind of information.
We have farmers cooperatives in all these villages, so
those cooperatives should do that. So I had another suggestion, you know, somebody was saying, you know, like sometimes all farmers may not be getting SMS, then what to do it? Then I suggested, I don't know, you can give me feedback whether it will work or not. What I suggested, you know, each village there is a pradhan. Do you have that?
Yes.
So you have one current pradhan and one is the one who has lost the election, past one. You give the information to both. Okay. So what the winner will give it to his people and the other fellow will give it to his people. So everybody will get it.
Right.
So at least if two people you give, so that means what we should target the leaders or pradhans of that particular area, pass on that information to him, and whatever you are saying, cooperatives, there the cooperative, who's the boss of that cooperative, you know, he should be the person who has this information. Yes. And he should pass it on. And then he should also tell whether these advisories which are being framed. Yeah, now he's saying, I am seeing here Menko, Zeb, all this, that should not be written. You also tell them very clearly, please do not mention the name of a pesticide. Only what they should say that their bulletin is that, please contact the, you know, they have a, you know, what he called as a unit called, you know, disease, something, district.
Advisory committee? Sir,
district.
Here we
district are. Something, some fellow, you know, who is takes care of a pesticide, fungicide thing, and so that person should be only, because sometimes I said Mancozeb. Who knows that Mancozeb may not be available in that area.
Correct.
So we should only say basic thing. What is? Yeah.
And sir, all these cooperatives whom we are talking about, and the people who are here work with organic farming. So we need to convert these.
Fantastic. They need not use this kind at all.
So what we'll do is, every week we will convert these advisories into organic advisories and then pass to the FPOs. I think that will be a great use. So every district we can do that.
Excellent. What I was suggesting, you know, they should, very rigorously, they should monitor the weather conditions.
Correct.
Because, you know, a particular pest comes and attacks the crop at a particular stage only.
Correct.
It will not attack at various stages of the crop. Particularly, suppose there are some will attack at seedling stage, some will attack at vegetative stage, some will attack at reproductive stage, some will at grain formation stage. So we have to be particular, like this pest affects only this particular stage. So be careful at that particular, do the rigorous monitoring. And if you find little symptoms, pluck the twig and dig a small pit in the soil and just put it there. So no need to take immediately spraying or that kind of thing. So I think that will be good thing. So but what I feel here still is that these advices are too big and too long. So you need to talk to the expert in that area and tell them, please reduce the content and make them very small and very, very, you know, pithy, so that it carries its meaning.
So what we are also trying is to, we have in three locations, we have the stations where we have the weather stations, automatic weather stations we have in three
Yes.
In this cooperative. So we are also mapping the local situation.
Yeah.
Try to use the district level forecast, which is already available, and see how much it matches. And
then you can also see the blocks also. For suppose in your area some blocks they must have started. So if that you have a block level, wherever block level is available, so block level can be given to them.
Correct. If the block level is there, it can be given. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And one more thing I will suggest is, you know, tell them, you know, sometimes, you know, there is a problem with the automatic weather stations. Because they are so sensitive, and sometimes there is some sabotage also. So sometimes they will find them, they may not be working also. So what I suggest is, first is that each village should have a simple rain gauge.
Okay.
So that you should, again, you know, it is, may not be very expensive, and if you are India Met department, it may take time. So I think these cooperatives can install their each village level each rain gauge, because that way, you know, you will be able to capture the variability, and then you can compare also. Then who knows, in later on you come to know, okay, this cluster of villages have similar kind of pattern. There is not no use to have the, you know, I mean,
weather stations are not required. Very true, sir. Weather stations are not required. I think if a simple rain gauge is there, and then you know how to use it, I think it is much easier.
And because rain is the major constant, you know, see, okay, temperature is also constant many times, but most of the times it is a rain which is a constraint, one. Second thing is, I don't know, you will know better than me. Earlier in entire southern India, it used to be tank irrigation.
Correct.
So we had all the ponds which were supplying the irrigation. But then what happened, you know, as the land prices increased, the mafia took over. One. Second thing, it became dumping grounds. And then ultimately, we lost many of the ponds which were precious resources. They were accumulating water. They were recharging the groundwater. And farmer used to get, you know, precious, what we call as life-saving irrigation from there.
Correct.
So that kind of pond regeneration has to be started. And before the monsoon season, what the farmer should do, if they have a pond in their area, immediately they should remove the excess mud in so that it has enough capacity to store more water. Okay. So that can be done. Any other questions?
Sir, there was one question. So where can I get the info on the blocks that are under IMD radar?
Okay, where I can get? I think because I have not opened that, you know, the, maybe.
Because here blocks are not given.
Block is not given?
That also blocks are not
given. Do one thing. I will tell you where is that. You please go to the front page again.
This one, sir? No?
Yeah, okay. Here, just a minute. You go to district and just see the block is also given.
Certainly, sir. It is
very, yes.
Say Andhra Pradesh.
Yeah, go to the district. Select the district, then go to the block.
Oh, almost all the districts are
all the district and all the blocks are covered. No, we are giving it, but only thing is that, you know, value addition is not done here. Block level, which state level, we do the value addition.
Okay.
This is only machine forecast.
Okay.
So, nonetheless, you can tell them that it is there. Start utilizing this thing, and let first see the block level forecast, and then come down to the district, and then come to the block level.
Okay, that's useful, sir. I think if block level information is available, then is done that some.
Only thing is that one needs to verify that how accurate.
Verify the information. Correct.
Yeah, it should not be too out.
How to understand this direction, sir? 180.
Yeah, very good, very good. That's a very good question. See. One thing is that when we say wind direction is southerly. Southerly means from south. It means the winds are coming from the south. Not going to south, coming from south. Always. Westerly wind means winds are coming from west and going towards the east. So one very important thing you should always know, when we direction means they are coming from that direction and going to the opposite direction. Okay? One. Second thing is simple. How to find out the direction? Just take small you know, soil in your fist and just throw it from a big height. Little height means, you know, from the high over your head, and then it will flow. Then you see the direction, which direction it is flowing. Or sometimes smoke is there, you did not burn something, but sometimes, you know, some burning is taking place, you come to know which direction the smoke is going. From there you come to know what is the direction of the wind.
But what is mentioned here is 189. How do we understand that, sir?
Okay, wonderful. See, it is like this, you know, north is your
Zero.
Okay? Zero. And south is 180.
North is zero, south is 180.
180. And east is 90.
East is 90.
Right. And west is 270.
Okay.
So it is like this. 0, 90, 180, right. 270, 360 ho jayega. Phir zero. So this is how it goes like this.
So the wind is moving. So 189 is...
It is 180. You take it as 180. So 180 means...
Coming from south.
It means south. It's a good indication. As long as you're getting winds from southerly direction, either southeastern direction means between east and south is southeast. Or you're getting winds from between west and southwest, they're always favorable that they will bring the moisture. But if they're coming from the north, then there will be dry winds. And then you have to see the location of the place. I don't know where is Alamuru. So it is a coastal place or away from the...
It's a coastal place.
It's a coastal place. So if a coastal place, you are having this kind of winds, I mean, one has to see. But then also, again, we can see weather chart. Just a minute. Can you go to the main site? Again, I will show you if there are weather charts there. From there, we will know the winds also. Just a minute. Satellite, radar, satellite, lightning. Okay. In the meantime, go to the radar. I want to show them radar also. And satellite also picture. So that they will... Radar. Click on radar. Okay. Now, if you see on the radar, which is the radar in your area? Visakhapatnam you can go.
Visakhapatnam.
Or Machilipatnam also is there.
Visakhapatnam, sir.
Okay. Visakhapatnam you go. I mean, somebody is now, right now, if you see, this shows, you know, some formation taking place here. If you click on this, there's a picture, you know, this one. Can you see this?
Which one, sir?
Right. You click this. Now see, it is showing you some different colors.
Correct.
So you from there, you know, somebody sitting here, it is very easy. There is not a rocket science. So different colors are shown here. So it says, if it is a bluish color, it is a very light rain. Less than, you know, you see this color here. Here, you bands. Here. These all, table is there. It is giving you a rain amount.
Okay. So here there is a high rain and here.
So now immediately seeing this, you can tell the farmer of this place, ki north of this place, about 100 kilometers from that Visakhapatnam, this area is going to get heavy rain. So there are chances of heavy rain in this area. So, but this is a now cast for the next 2 hours. So they should immediately tell that area people, look, you are going to get there is a CB cloud forming in your area. You will get a precipitation and make arrangement for excess water drainage. Immediately that advisory should go to them.
Correct.
This is how it can help. And safety point of view. And again, if you see in a radar, if you go back. So, same radar. Here somewhere, you know, just a minute. Yeah, I clicked on this black one. Black table is there. Click on this. This is beautiful. Can you make it a little bigger?
Looks like there is
it,
no...
It is of sex. No problem. Yeah, correct. Now you see it is marking on the left side. So from bottom you see 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer, 3 kilometer. Now you see here the winds here down below. Come niche. Yeah. These are the winds it is showing at different levels in the atmosphere.
Okay.
So lower level you see up to 0.6 kilometer, the winds are southerly. They are coming from south side. Down below. Where you have this thing. That shows these winds are from south. They are coming from down up. And if you go up 1.8 kilometer, here the winds are coming from west. The direction has changed. And in between, they were northerly, 1.2 kilometer. So you will come to know. So depending on the cloud, if cloud is at this height, it decides which direction the cloud is going to move.
Okay.
So this winds will decide the movement of the cloud. So if somebody wants to know if there is a cloud, which direction it's going to move? These winds will decide which direction it will move. So So there's a lot of information is available. So I think what we need to do is that we need to conduct more and more meetings at the farmer level.
Yes. And also show the local languages.
local
probably language. We need to build local language information, yes, on how to, yes, understand these data and then, yeah, how to interpret and use it.
Correct. And I'm going to tell you one thing. Next year I'm retiring, and after that I don't want to do any job. I just want to do this kind of social service for the farmers.
Come down, so sir. Come down to Hyderabad.
By help, I will come there. You don't have to pay me anything.
Yes, come down, sir. That will be very great. Yeah.
So now you can go to satellite. I will show you the satellite thing now. Please go to satellite.
Okay. Where is this?
One more thing. Nowcast. Click on Nowcast first. Nowcast here.
Here.
Nowcast, yeah.
District wise.
Correct. Oh, is it there? No, nothing is there?
Nothing is there.
Station wise.
It is coming. It, yeah,
it is there. It is there. You can click on your, go to your district. Yeah, yeah. Go to your district. Boundaries are there. West Godavari.
Yes. East Godavari, no
warning. No warning. You go to this one, which is this in dark color. Yellow color, go yellow color.
Guntur light rain.
5 millimeter of rain. Next 2 hours.
Prakasham,
there is rain. No, 5 millimeters.
Karnool, moderate thunderstorms.
Yes, you see, all this information is available. They should utilize this information. Radar, next one, satellite and lightning. Click this. So now, see this little go up. Yeah. Now you see in your area, these are the area where right now thunderstorm is happening. Lightning is happening. See, you saw the names of the different agromet field unit. What first you have to do is find out in your state how many agromet field units are there.
That we know. Yeah, yeah.
Right. And now you see those agromet field units, because basically what is happening is, if the person sitting on this agromet field unit is a very sincere person, dedicated person, he will do a better job. If he's not a dedicated person, he will just make his routine kind of advisory and throw it.
Correct.
So we need to ensure now these fellows, like weather department also and state agriculture, they get huge amount of money and they should be accountable.
Correct.
So please ask them, like, and then based on that, choose some good districts and start monitoring them. And then first thing is that you should have the crop calendar.
Yeah.
What are the major crops? Because we may not be covering all the crops. So select maybe four major crops. Have their calendar ready, right from your, pre-sowing. That is.
Yeah. We have that, sir. We are already prepared that.
To maturity. Already it is there. And we also know which are the critical stages. You also know the crop is more, prone to pest or disease at that particular stage. Or where water stress can lead to reduction in the yield. That also. And then you also know the water requirements of the crop.
Correct.
It needs 3 irrigation or 4 irrigation. Correct. Then you know the climatology, what is the rainfall of that area.
Correct.
So how much it gets, does it meet your all the water requirement? No, it may not meet. Okay, so then question comes, sometime what happens, your rainfall amount is less or it is highly variable, then you need to find out in 10-year period, how many times you get drought-like conditions, once or twice or 3 times or 4 times, or if 4 or more times, if it is 4 or more times, why you are growing that kind of crop? If you are growing a water-intensive crop, you should not grow at all. Cropping should be according to the crop, your climate. Cropping pattern should be as per your climate.
Correct.
Right. So after that, you decide that rainfall is highly variable, it is less. So you should go for millets. Okay. Millet you have gone. Now you know millets need 3 irrigation, but your rain is meeting your only 2 requirements. Now where the 3rd requirement is going to come from? It will come from the harvested water. Okay. So some kind of arrangement must be made at the local level through pond or where water is this thing.
Or irrigation.
Something. So that drought proofing needs to be done. What we have done, we have not been able to drought proof. Every time we talk about drought proofing, nobody is doing drought proofing. Drought proofing is what crop to put and life saving irrigation. At least one life saving, because you will never find that for 1 month together there will be no rain.
Correct.
15 days is possible. But if 15 days there is no rain and you have saved one irrigation, if you do that, next 15 days it goes, the crop will be okay. So it's a saving of one life. If you can ensure that, you will doubt proof your region.
Correct. I think that's something which we need to plan out.
Yeah.
And
then another thing is that, you know, that it's called microclimate manipulation.
Mm-hmm.
So microclimate manipulation is like what we do mulching sometimes when you have moisture in the soil and coming days temperatures are going to shoot up. So you cover the dry leaves, that particular place, the whatever moisture is there, it will remain intact. It will not be evaporated. Or suppose you have to irrigate and next 5 days temperature is going to shoot up. So you should not apply irrigation in the morning. You should apply irrigation evening and night. So there are many such things. I think we can keep on interacting on regular basis.
Sure, sir.
I'll be more than happy to share all those information and collect questions. And then we can
do I'll keep sending you the questions and all.
Excellent, excellent.
Thanks. That's very useful, sir.
So if there are no more, yeah.
If there are no more questions, I think I thank you, sir. Thank you very much. It was
Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
And it was very useful for us, and probably one of the best interactions we had, because we were doing several such interactions to understand how we can use technology, how we can use various policies, and then how can we use various schemes and all. I think it was very useful. Thank you very much, sir.